Dear students, let us look at one of the very major plays of William Shakespeare, that is Julius Caesar. Shakespeare's career as a dramatist expands to a very vast period. In terms of a number of plays, Shakespeare's career as a dramatist is expansive. Julius Caesar, one of the great tragedies, or what we generally call as matured tragedies, belongs to the third phase of Shakespeare's career as a dramatist. The first period is the period of a very apprenticeship of Shakespeare, and the second period is involving his technique, knowledge and thinking, where the third period is successful in reflecting all his matured stage of writing career. The third phase of his writing is full of great tragedies. When we listen to the name of Shakespeare, we generally come across the names of great tragedies like King Lear, Macbeth, Othello, Hamlet, etc. And Julius Caesar belongs to that third phase of writing. Shakespeare's Julius Caesar is one of the great tragedies. The play Julius Caesar is based on Roman history. That is why Julius Caesar is significant as one of the historical plays of William Shakespeare. Shakespeare wrote many historical plays. The plays which are based on Greek and Roman history, the emperors of Rome or England, the two nations, Greece, Rome or England, happen to be full of the sources for writing historical plays, and Shakespeare utilized that history. Julius Caesar is one such play that is based on Roman history of the reign of Julius Caesar, the emperor of Rome. The play that takes the days of Julius Caesar's life, that is during the days of 50 to 40 BC in the life of Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar, who was ruling Rome, was not accepted as king officially. In other words, he was not crowned, but still Julius Caesar enjoyed all the power and administration. The play Julius Caesar centers around this day of 40 to 50 BC in the life of Julius Caesar, the prime time of Caesar's life. The Roman history of the days of Julius Caesar is not only the life of Julius Caesar, it is the prime time of the life of such characters like Brutus, that is Marcus Brutus, and Mark Antony or Marcus Antonius, and Cassius, Casca, Cinna, Decius, Brutus, etc. All these characters are real characters of Roman history who lived along with Julius Caesar when Julius Caesar was ruling Rome. Julius Caesar conducted many conquests and was victorious. He went to different parts of the world and made himself a glorious emperor. But at the same time, Julius Caesar had created many enemies in his life. This play of William Shakespeare titled Julius Caesar that was written in 1602 centers around that personal tragedy along with history. It is a personal tragedy of Caesar also. It is not only the personal tragedy of Julius Caesar, it is the personal tragedy of personalities like Cassius, Brutus, Casca, Cinna, etc. It is mainly the personal tragedy of Brutus, because Brutus was like an eye of Julius Caesar. Brutus was a right hand of Caesar and he was the light of Julius Caesar. Caesar has accepted, admired Brutus as the light of his life. And Brutus was always called as noble Brutus. That was the high position given to Brutus in the life of Julius Caesar. But where is the tragedy in the life of Julius Caesar is, Caesar's conquests, his victories, his glory and his admiration, his administration all were accepted. But Julius Caesar at one stage was considered as ambitious. It was Caius Cassius who seeds the suspicion of ambition in the life of Julius Caesar. Cassius and Brutus come to an understanding that Caesar is growing ambitious and considered as over ambitious in his life. And this ambition is a political ambition of Caesar to become a dictator. Cassius and Brutus, who suspect Caesar as ambitious, doesn't stop at just thinking that Caesar is ambitious, but they think that Caesar is growing a dictator. Cassius was once upon a time considered as a great warrior who could not be defeated by anybody. Cassius in the play Julius Caesar gives an example to Brutus that once there was a swimming contest in the Tiber River. Julius Caesar, as a mark of his overconfidence and high sense of physical power, challenges Cassius whether he could have a courage to swim across the very powerful waves in Tiber River. Cassius accepts the challenge, and within no time, very soon, Caesar was tired of swimming and Caesar was actually in danger of losing his life. Cassius was very powerful swimmer, undefeatable swimmer. Julius Caesar failed to survive and he begged for help. It was Cassius who saved Julius Caesar from the chafing Tiber River. Such a Cassius, a great hero, is neglected. Cassius thinks that he and Brutus were sidelined and they were cornerized in the over-ambitious nature of Julius Caesar. That is why Cassius tries to convince Brutus and win his heart in his favor and develop a conspiracy against Caesar. The conspiracy is one of the major elements in the play that is a result of the suspicion against Caesar's ambition and dictatorial nature. Cassius and Brutus, who consider Caesar's ambition as dictatorial attitude, are moving towards colossal power and dictatorship. develop a conspiracy. They take the help of Cinna, Casca, Trebonius, Decius, etc. to make their conspiracy a successful one against Caesar. As a part of that conspiracy, when Caesar was trying to come to Parliament, Senate Hall, he was murdered. And Julius Caesar, who considered Brutus as his eyes, was shocked to see that Brutus also stabbed him. And the last words of Julius Caesar, "Et tu, Brute," or in other words, "You too, Brutus," are the remarkable expression of a great personal tragedy in the life of Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar, who believed that Brutus is the second soul of his own life, was shocked to see that such a dear friend Brutus could stab him to death. And the great treacherous moment in the life of Julius Caesar comes when Brutus, Casca, Cinna, Cassius and others stab him to death. The great conspiracy or that great tragedy in the life of Julius Caesar was unbelievable. How the trusted friends can turn into foes in the life of a great ruler is witnessed and realized in the play Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar is very significant because Caesar, who comes on the stage for a short period, is very powerful. Caesar dead is more powerful than Caesar alive is a very powerful commentary made on the play Julius Caesar. It is true. Julius Caesar, after his murder, becomes a very strong element that Brutus, Cassius, Casca and others cannot escape. The sin or the power of crime that haunts them like a ghost. And Caesar becomes so powerful after his death. During his lifetime, Caesar comes on the stage for a short period in Julius Caesar. I mean in Shakespeare's play, but after his death, he rules the whole scene, making Brutus and Cassius unable to escape, and they fail, they accept their death. Tragedy in Julius Caesar is multiple. It is a multifaceted tragedy, personal and social, political, historical tragedy. That tragedy is not one person's tragedy, it is many persons' tragedy. Shakespeare weaves the plot in such a way that there is high admiration to Caesar, enmity, suspicion, conspiracy, over-ambition, political power, gain and a battle for power, etc. And historical places that are realistic and they are used as a battlefield also in Shakespeare's Julius Caesar. Shakespeare weaves the whole play in a full-length, well-knit plot constructed one. Thank you.